So here's this pesky loop that didn't quite work out for us. We want to keep asking the user to enter a value less than 100, and we want to keep doing it while they enter a value greater or equal than 100. But really, what we want to do is we want to go through the loop once, and then do the check, and then if the check failed, go through the loop again, and so on. The key is we want to go through it at least once. The way to do that in Java is to move the while statement, the while condition, to the bottom, and to add the word do to the top. You have the word do on the top, the while condition on the bottom, and this is called a do loop. Let's look at a program that uses it. So here's our program. It has the do loop that you've just seen. So we keep asking the user, please enter an integer less than 100 until they do. In other words, we stay in the loop while the input is greater or equal than 100. And then this program doesn't do anything with it. It just says, thank you for entering a value less than 100. Let's run this program so you can see it in action. The program has started. It asks for an integer less than 100. We'll be annoying and put in 200. We get another prompt, so we'll be annoying again. And we could do this forever or not. And now the program simply says, thank you for entering 90. That's the most common reason, really, to use the do loop for input validation. And the reason you need the do loop is simply you've got to get at least one input from the user before you know whether to complain or not. So this is the situation where you've got to enter the loop at least once before you know what to do. That's exactly the point of the do loop. The do loop enters the loop at least once, whereas the while loop might never enter the loop.